we're going to go into the marketing portion of the day here, and we have a great set of partnerships. We partner with the CIO Council to bring a lot of CIOs into this event, and this time we partner for the first time with the CMO Council because we really want to make this an event for both CMOs and CIOs. And our next speaker, Donovan Neil May, is the executive director of the CMO Council, and he's going to share some new data and research with you today. Donovan.
Thank you very much, Eric.
Thank you.
All right. Whenever a marketer comes on stage, people exit. I like that. The good thing is I represent a stakeholder group that has the money. So we have 10,000 members in 110 countries around the world. Our members spend about $500 billion on marketing. And as Eric noted earlier, maybe 37 billion of that is on new technology. Why should data drive marketing? We've done a large number of studies, and what comes out of a lot of our studies and this most recent report from Turn and Forbes is that organizations that are leaders in data-driven marketing report far higher levels of customer engagement and market growth than their laggard counterparts. However, a lot of the problem that we face has to do with the use of the data. Marketers are very good on the creative side, on the branding side, on road mapping and identifying and segmenting their audiences, but they have yet to come to grips with how to do data. So one of our biggest initiatives is how do we integrate and align the CMO and the CIO? How do we get these new emerging titles, Chief Digital Officer, we have somebody from McDonald's coming today, Chief Data Officer, Chief Relationship Officer, Chief Experience Officer, all new titles that really should be under the remit of the Chief Marketing Officer. But bottom line is, if you look at what's happening today in our studies that we've just undertaken this year, managing the data explosion, and we've all heard about the deluge of data and how that's coming down and what that's how that's impacting all facets of business, but managing that explosion, only 30% of our members believe they do that well. Centralizing fragmented data. There are about 3,000 or so marketing applications or marketing-related applications out there. If you go to Capterra, check out all the different segments and categories of software. There's probably around 3,000 different offerings, and that's multiplying daily. So all of those applications produce new sources of data. What do you do with that data? You need marketing middleware to kind of tie it all together. You know, insights and analytics to try to get some actionable, valuable direction for decision support. Creating more personalized experience, less than 30% say they can do that. Some companies, of course, have taken this to a very advanced level. Others are still languishing and don't quite know what to do with all the data they have. What's the problem with data sprawl today? When you look at who owns data, that's the real challenge. We've got increasingly globalized companies. We have big problems of cross-border data migration and integration. Data is in multiple formats. There's multiple regulations and requirements. It's not easy to move data around the world. We have multiple sources of data, as you can see. Touch points with customers are multiplying constantly. New channels of interaction and engagement. There's silos of data all over the organization. People have got lost and languishing data they don't even know about. It's a big problem for marketers. So the notion of multiple sources, silos, and owners of data is a big issue. More apps, channels, and touch points. We've talked about that. And then the big problem of who's going to integrate this, who's going to extract it. And it's not just the internally generated data. The big problem today is what comes from outside. How do you enrich the profiles? How do you acquire, work with third parties? to source data from the Internet of Things and from all the other sources of multiplying sources of data that are out there. Next, what the real challenge for marketers is to look at predicting, understanding intentions, determining and forecasting what people are going to do, what they're going to acquire, what they're going to be predisposed to, what are their preferences. So when you look at data and the types of data that we're capturing today, we've got attitudinal data, behavioral data, transactional data. For example, Catalina, company down in Florida, collects about 350 million, or processes and filters 300 million transactions a week at 30,000 retail outlets, drugstores, supermarkets, convenience stores, and uses that data to serve out personalized promotional offers based on your purchasing patterns, you know, your household consumption information, right? Social data. I just got back from South Africa. If you look at the whole social media scene, it's massive in these emerging markets. Probably 80% of that social media content and activity is through mobile devices. And you can, with that, identify a lot of locational information. You can identify environmental information. You can also capture operational information as you start to think about sensors everywhere. So there's this whole world of data, and all of that is focused on one thing. We want to get a 360-degree view of the customer from a market intelligence standpoint. What I'm saying is we're seeing the advent of what I call direct relationship disruption. About back in 1985, I started working with Dell Computer. 5 years, from 60 million to a half a billion, going public, Michael Dell had a view and a vision. This is before the advent of all of these other tools and technologies for interacting and engaging and sharing. But his disruptive model was build to order, and of course, the whole notion of the supply chain, and how do you disrupt the incumbent dealer's infrastructure to provide a much more personalized, a much more cozy, intimate relationship where you understood a lot more about the actual application environment. And most hardware vendors struggle to get to that end customer and understand where and how that end customer is using their product. Dell did this years ago. As you see, E-Trade, another disruptor, and Netflix, another disruptor, Amazon, Intuit, all of these companies have certain common characteristics and traits. And, excuse me, the direct relationship disruption model is all about deep data, know heck of a lot about who you're working with, who you're engaging with, what their experiences are all about, understanding their preferences, their purchasing habits, what they're doing. Always on connectivity, access 7x24. Anytime, anywhere, any place, you can access. And lastly, most importantly, frictionless commerce. So you got to have an environment in which people can engage and blend content and commerce to be more helpful, to be more informed, to advise, to notify, to help people make decisions faster so that your conversion rates are higher. So what that results in is ultimately a valued, personalized, and predictable experience. So we believe that's the future, and companies that are heading that direction will be showing much more traction in the marketplace. I've got a few minutes left here. There's five marketing technology drivers that I think those of you out there who are building apps, starting companies, or crossing the chasm and elevating your growth. Bottom line is, marketers look at five areas: relationships, revenue, response, rationalization, and ROI. So when you start to think about relationships, we want more insight. We want to understand more about what our customers need, want, prefer, desire, what their pain points are, what their problems are. We want intimacy. We want them to feel that they're being treated preferentially and intimately. And we want interaction. We want to interact a lot. We want them to feel welcome and to feel invited and to participate with us. The next area, of course, is revenue. Everybody talks about acquisition and customer acquisition, getting into contention, getting into close, getting into deal negotiation. How do we do that faster, quicker, better? Retention. There's massive churn rates in a lot of these subscription-driven businesses. How do you deal with churn? How do you actually deal with recovery and reactivation of lost account? Who do you know has departed, and why did they depart? Who has that information? You folks can help that way. Monetization. It's called upsell. It's called cross-sell. It's called further account penetration. It's about sales intelligence systems that could direct and focus and program sales resources to be more productive and efficient. Next area is response. Everybody wants their campaigns to be more targeted. If you look at what happens with large social mass customization of campaigns, where many different creative versions of messaging is done on a platform that can determine who are the most compatible consumers for your brand, and how do you send personalized messages to those across, you know, in some cases, hundreds of millions of consumers. And what we're seeing is the need for delivering messages at the right time, obviously in the right place, with the right offer. Mobility technologies obviously help a lot with that, particularly with the new crop of consumers. And then when you look at operational issues, 50% of CMOs are hired to fix broken marketing organizations. And the important thing for them is to look at, how do I introduce automation into my change-resistant organization, to an organization, a marketing supply chain that's more fragmented today, more distributed today? How do I increase collaboration and effectiveness within that marketing organization? How to increase efficiency of time and effort? And how do I increase productivity? Big problem in evaluating vendors and partners. And then lastly, ROI, marketing performance measurement, the area that everybody has to spend a whole lot more time when you have a chief procurement officer, chief financial officer, chief executive officer, line of business leader, all looking at marketing and wanting to understand how is spend impacting. So measurement, accountability, and control, budget control, big area of concern for a lot of marketing organizations. And all of these things are areas where you folks out there who have nifty new technology and ideas, this will give you a little bit of a roadmap as to where you might want to focus your time and attention. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Don. Please stay on stage.